Ed, or wanna make dreams come true?
Yeah!
Let's push the button.
Coming up on Day Show. Skin our style? Why not? As we give these cabin lads the most epic makeover ever. Sharon Shannon makes a fiddle player's dream come true. He's helped make our dreams come true. Now, Louis Walls takes an X Factor fan behind the scenes. Plus, One Dreamer jets off to Paris to help make the magic happen at Disneyland.
See the day, trying to fight it, it's all in vain. Cause we know the night wins, but we don't care. We're lighting up like a flare. And I will always know where you are. Cause I can see you glow in the dark. We got the stars and moon in us. We're always gonna be blue.
Are you guys excited?
Yeah!
It seems like County Cavan is suffering from a serious fashion crisis.
Best friends Philip, Michal, and Sean wrote to the Dream Factory saying, "Sup, John and Edward, we think your style is totally jawsome." Well, you know it is. "Could you please design something totally jelly for us to wear?" No fear. When fashion calls, we always answer by telephone.
Yeah, what's up?
So guys, we are here outside Sean and Michael's house. We are now gonna ring the doorbell and surprise them and tell them that their dream is about to come true. What's up, guys? What's up, Sean? What's up, Michael? Who's Sean and who's Michael?
I'm Sean.
And who are you?
Michael.
It's John Edward K. We're here to make your dream come true. You said you wanna have cool clothes like us, so we're gonna make you guys something really, really cool.
When Edward came in, I was amazed because you don't really see that every day.
High fives all around. Let's do this.
I wanted to look like Jared a bit more and for Jared to design Austria outfits.
Would Jared wear this? Don't think so. Would Jared wear these? Maybe if they were going surfing. Would Jared wear this? I don't think so.
They threw out all our clothes on our bed. They were spiking up our hair so we'd look like Jared.
Oh, yeah. Yeah. Hey, Sean, I'm John, that's Michael, and that's Edward. And we are now going to go into your friend's house. What's his name?
Phil.
All right, let's go do this. Come on, dude. Slow pokes. We're now at the front of his house. This is our friend, Philip. We're not going to surprise him. What's up, Philip? It's John and Edward. What's going on, Philip? Let's get in here. Let's go into your house.
I thought I might have been asleep, but then I realized, right, no, I'm not asleep, okay?
So how are you?
Good.
Do you even know you're coming to your house?
No.
Were you eating bread?
I was.
Because you got bread in your face.
Yeah, I was eating toast.
Phil, you're probably wondering why we're here, okay? We're going to make you an awesome, cool outfit. Can we all go OMG? OMG! Yeah! Alright, let's see what you got. Would Jared wear this? Yes, they would. Would Jared wear this denim jacket? Yes, they would. Would we wear this cool red t-shirt? Maybe. We go.
They spiked up my hair, and that was pretty cool as well. They spiked it up like theirs.
We now have an army of Jedwards.
Now we need to ask you guys more about what you guys like to wear. What's your favourite outfit that Minerva have worn?
The Eurovision one.
Yeah, I like that.
Which year? The lipstick ones or the waterline ones?
The waterline ones.
Or would you like to wear a space outfit?
No.
Me and Erin always wear matching outfits, okay? Would you guys wear matching outfits? All three wearing the exact same outfit?
Yeah.
They don't measure us photos and sketches, so they'll be able to design outfits for us.
I can't wait for Jedward to design his outfits and to be on the show.
We're now going to go make them. They're going to totally rock. Peace out, people. What was it like? Were you really thankful for Sean and Micheál for, like, bringing us to your house?
Yeah.
Well, say thanks to them now.
Thank you.
How did you feel when we all came to your house going, is this actually like a dream?
It was kind of like just awkward.
Awkward. Sean is the only person with hair spiky. What's going on, guys? You're meant to be twins. You're meant to have spiky hair together.
I didn't have any gel left.
Can I get an aww? No gel. When we came to your house, I designed really cool outfits, and so did John. Are you excited about seeing those outfits?
Yeah.
Well, let's check out the outfits. Are you guys ready to see your outfits? This is Philip. He's sporting the latest season's look, gold llama, top to toe, and he's rocking that look. He also loves cuddly animals and dreams of world peace. Coming up next is none other than Micheál, sporting a gladiator look and the essential knee defenders. Micheál enjoys going snowball fights in the winter, and he also likes building sandcastles. Woo! Next up, we've got Sean, and he's sporting, well, let's face it, the same outfit as the other two. Sean has a bubbly sense of humor, and he says meeting Jedward has been the highlight of his life. Philip, Sean, and Micheál, that's it, guys. You guys each get an OMG badge.
As you can tell, we love traditional music, and so does our next dreamer, 14-year-old Siobhan O'Gara from none other than Mayo. Told me and Edward, I've been playing the fiddle for almost 7 years. My dream is to play the Galway girl on stage with Sharon Shannon. So we got straight on the phone. Yo, 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 what's up, Sharon Shannon? Want to be on the Dream Factory? Of course I do.
I'm really excited because I'm going to go in to meet Siobhan and tell her that her dream is going to come true.
I just thought she was coming in to buy something in the shop, and then she came over and said my name.
Hello. Hi, Siobhan.
Hi.
I'm Sharon Shannon, and I hear you wrote into Jedward's Dream Factory.
Yeah.
So, John and Edward sent me here to help to make your dream come true.
I think Siobhan was completely in shock.
So, will I get my card in and we'll have a little bit of a session?
Yeah. I've been playing the fiddle for nearly 7 years, and Galway Girl was one of the first tunes, and I've just been playing it ever since.
One, two, three.
It's a chance in a lifetime to play with someone like Sharon Shannon. I've always been a big fan. She's such a talented musician, and I've always wanted to see her live, but I never got the chance.
Deadly, deadly, deadly. Not a bother. I'm playing with a 40-piece orchestra tomorrow for a huge big crowd, massive big audience. And you're going to be playing Galway Girl with us. So how do you feel about playing with the orchestra tomorrow?
Nervous.
Well, I'm always nervous, so we can be nervous together. Don't worry. I'll look after you.
Hey, how are you doing?
This is Siobhan, everybody.
I'm a massive fan of Sharon, and to be sitting beside her playing was just amazing. I've done all the rehearsals and the sound check, and now I just have to play in front of the audience. I'm just going to pretend they're not there.
The lady from Currafin, up the banner. There's only one, Sharon Shannon.
When I was standing at the side of the stage, I was really nervous.
I'm going to go on in a few minutes now and play. It doesn't feel like it's real. It's just like, I feel like it's a dream or something.
We have a very special guest. Would you please welcome the beautiful Siobhan O'Gara?
When I started actually playing, I just got really into it and really enjoyed it. I feel really proud of myself now that I've actually gone up and played in front of that many people. When the song finished, everyone started clapping and it felt really good that they were clapping for us. It was everything I wished for and more. Thank you, Jedward, for making my dream come true.
What's the name of your dog?
How are you? How's it going?
What's the name of your dog?
This is Lily here.
Why'd you bring Lily today?
Lily's here because she is the star of my new video.
Madra?
Which I made to promote animal rescue.
This is like the first dog ever on set. OMG. Can you do any tricks? No tricks? Paw? He's sitting right now, so that's a good trick. Lie down. Siobhan, were you so excited when you saw Sharon walk into the shop?
It was amazing. Like, it was just a dream come true.
She's like the best in the world.
Yeah.
You're the best in the world.
And you guys got to perform together with like a live band and everything in front of thousands of people. How did that feel?
It was really nerve-wracking, but once I went on, I was like, it was really cool.
Sharon, okay, you need to like teach John how to play the button accordion. Can you give him like a lesson right now?
Can you give me a master lesson, John? Get over there. Okay, I'm gonna go in the middle of you, okay? So, in, out, and then next one.
Great crack, wasn't it? Anyway, Siobhan, Sharon, John, you guys have all been amazing, okay? But before you go, we gotta give you your OMG badge!
Coming up after the break, he's helped make our dreams come true. Now, Louis Walsh takes an X Factor fan behind the scenes. And one dreamer jets off to Paris to help make the magic happen at Disneyland.
Hey guys, I'm John.
And I'm Edward.
And together we are... And we have got a surprise for someone in the audience. John O'Connor! John O'Connor, take a seat. Do you have any idea why you're sitting on our comfy couch?
No.
We hear that you're a huge X Factor fan.
Yeah.
We spoke to Louis Walsh, okay, and guess what? You're going to the X Factor! Okay, you're gonna go to X Factor, okay? You're gonna get to go to the show, you're gonna go behind the scenes with Louis. You'll get to see Talisa what she looks like before without any makeup. Yeah, that's what I'm talking about. Excited?
Yeah.
You look excited. Give it up for John! He's going to the X Factor!
Just landed in London and now I'm on the way to Louis' hotel. I'm such a big fan of the X Factor. It's always been a dream to go backstage and meet everyone. I can't believe it's actually happening.
Good afternoon, Mr. O'Connor. Mr. Walsh is waiting for you in the drawing room.
Thank you. The hotel was really nice and big and it was really posh.
So John, how are you?
I'm good.
Welcome to London and the Kensington Hotel. But I hear you got some questions for me.
Yeah.
What have you got? What? Ask me anything.
Okay. If you could mentor another category, which would it be?
I would pick the boys because I love Jermaine. Absolutely love Jermaine and James Arthur. I think Jermaine is probably one of my favourite singers ever on X Factor.
He was really nice, he answered all my questions. Which judge did you get on with the best?
I think probably Talisa. I look at Talisa as being like a sister of mine. You know, if you had a really bold sister that was That was fun and games. I think that's Talisa.
Who fights the most backstage?
Backstage, historically, on X Factor, most of the rows are usually between the girls. But they're usually fighting over who's going to look the best or who's going to have the best shoes.
And do you have any gossip from backstage?
Any gossip? Lots, but I can't tell you.
We went back to the X Factor and met the contestants.
Hiya.
This is John from Dublin.
Oh, nice to meet you.
Hi. Hey, John, you're right.
I met Charlie from MK1 and Jade.
And what's the best part about the competition?
Louis.
I was going to say, meeting Louis. Louis
and Talisa.
Louis
and Talisa, yeah. And the girls want to come to Dublin for a day or two.
We're going to come to Dublin.
So yeah. If we do that,
we'll link up in Dublin.
Definitely.
We'll definitely let you know. Definitely. That'll be really cool. You can show us some cool places. We've got to do makeup.
Got to do
but
hair.
I'm sure we'll pop in and see you.
Lots of makeup.
Lots and lots, yeah. Nice to meet you.
It's lovely meeting you.
See you
later.
Thank you.
Oh,
that was really cool.
Hi. This is John from Dublin, and
you want to. Lovely to meet you. Are you all right?
Yeah.
So are you here for the night?
Yeah.
To watch the show?
Yeah.
Brilliant. And who are you most looking forward to seeing?
Me.
Louis.
Me.
Apart from you don't have to
it's
say.
It's all about me.
You don't have to say Louis just because he's here. You can be honest.
I got my hair done by Louis' stylist.
What do you think of that?
A little bit of texture.
Get the X Factor treatment.
All the Louis groups, they all came into his dressing room, so I got to meet all of them.
Hi. Hi, are you all right?
Yeah.
I'm George.
Hi, I'm John.
Nice to meet you. What's your name?
John.
So what's the best part about being in Union J?
Being in Union J?
Yeah.
The boys and just like the energy that we have. It's wicked.
And what's the best bit about the whole show?
The best bit about the whole show is performing to you guys because it's just really fun.
Who are your favourite artists or bands?
In the world?
Yeah.
I love Ed Sheeran. One Direction are pretty cool. Just John and Edward.
I'm Josh.
I'm George.
And together we are
Gosh.
Isn't it like your dream to watch X Factor?
Yeah.
Big high five. I'm gonna love it. It's awesome.
Hey, good luck tonight.
Thank you.
Thanks, buddy.
Lovely meeting you, man. Lovely
meeting you.
Thank you. The new One Direction.
We have a member.
Oh, this is perfect.
Thank you. Thanks
very much. George gets too old, John, we'll pull you in.
Later,
mate.
Bye
bye.
We actually got tickets to actually go to the live show, so we got to sit in the audience and watch the whole show.
It was so good to meet everyone today, and I can't wait for the show to start.
When the show was over, all the contestants came out and we got pictures with them all. I just want to say one thing to Jedward. Thank you so much for making my dream come true.
Is 10-year-old Kalina Donnelly from Kilkenny. She wrote to us saying, I love two things. One, science and technology. Two, Mickey Mouse. My dream would be to combine the two and find out how everything works behind the scenes at Disneyland. Please, Jedward, make my dream come true. Well, get ready for the surprise of your life, Kalina, because it's coming right now to you.
My mom, me and my dad went up to the airport. I thought that my dad was going to London and that we were going to say goodbye.
Kalina, Jedward asked me to give you this.
You told us that you love Disneyland and that's why you're on Next Flight to Paris. I felt really happy and excited, but I was shocked because we were going immediately.
It's all right.
It's okay. It's okay, darling.
Yeah, it's all right.
Yeah.
Nice. One, two, three, OMG. Can we do that?
No.
Oh, okay.
Bye, Kalina. Have fun. You want to be an Imagineer?
Yeah, absolutely.
Well, you are an honorary Imagineer for the day, so let's get going.
Okay.
Be our
Come on, Tati.
Guest. Be our guest. Put our service to the test. Tie your napkin round your neck, Sherry, and we provide the rest.
We went over to the costume designer for the parades. She had a few costumes for me to look at. How long did this take to make?
We spent at least 2 to 3 months doing designs, finding the right fabrics. And then we spent lots of time doing the embroideries to make sure that it's magic.
She let me try on a little skirt and a tiara and nice white gloves.
Transformation.
So I felt like a princess.
I think we need to think about the shoes.
Now I'm the king of the swingers.
Ooh. Here we go! My dad's a bit of a big kid. He's kind of the biggest kid I ever saw. So he's the perfect guy to be going around Disneyland with me.
Oh, ooby-doo, ooby-doo. I want to be like you. Hop-dee-ooby-doo. I want to walk like you. Chip-talk like you. Choo-choo.
Baloo was on the float with me, and also King Louis was on it. They were high-fiving me and dancing. The bunch of smiling faces just made me so happy. I'm very interested in how to make all the illusions happen.
Hi, Kleena. I'm Ben Spaulding. Nice to meet you.
Ben is responsible for behind the scenes of the evening show.
We've got pyro, we've got laser, we've got video. See this fog? It looks like the castle's on fire. So that's all the technicians testing everything there. 3, 2, 1, say go.
Go.
There you go.
When I said go, the fountain shot up to make a water show in the middle of the day. It was just amazing.
Woo, yay!
Ben brought me to the control room. It's really important because everyone in there has a part to play. Someone controls the fireworks, the sound, the light, and the images. It's bringing all those together at the right time. That makes the show so amazing.
The next test that they're going to do is for the second star. There's a technician going up there, right up to the top of the castle, to be physically present.
I'm scared
of heights, are you?
Yeah. I prefer to be sitting here and going up there. I felt so excited to see the show, to see what it looks like all put together. Best seats in the house. I'm special. I'm a VIP. That mini seat.
Yeah, sorry.
Fireworks started coming and then loads of flames started coming up. You could feel the heat coming at you.
Oh my God, that is deadly.
When you wish upon a star, makes no difference who you are.
It was a very special end to an incredible day. This is the most amazing, spectacular, awesome, deadly, unreal experience of my life.
Hey, Kleena, what's going on? What was it like being at Disneyland behind the scenes?
Deadly. It was the most amazing thing.
Minnie and Mickey Mouse actually, like, going out? Were Mickey Mouse and Minnie Mouse kissing?
They were.
Really?
That is classified information. Like.
Because you're backstage and you're doing all the crazy waterworks and different things. Were you afraid that if you touched something that something could have gone crazily wrong?
Well, yeah. At one point, there was a water show going on. And I was like, what if I touch that button? Like, will something go off or will I stop the whole show or something?
Did you get to skip the queues?
We went on It's a Small World and there was like a half an hour queue and we just got to get on the first empty boat that came.
What do you guys think? Should they have a Jevra ride?
Yeah.
Wouldn't that make Disneyland way cooler?
Yeah.
Yes, it would. Clean out, okay? Me and Eric got something really, really special for you. It's an IMG Jevra Dream Factory bag!
Thank you.
Guys, it has been another crazy busy day in the Dream Factory.
Yeah, Eric, I loved every second of it. It was totally awesome and out of this world. But until next time, keep dreaming!
Next time in the Dream Factory. Top Chef Nev McGuire cooks up a dream to remember for this dreamer. We take over Timahoe National School in Kildare. Rhino Shocknessy is in the Dream Factory to make a fan's dream come true. And there's a prickly problem for this young animal lover as she joins the DSPCA. OMG!